Are you interested in creating your own VR app? Maybe you want to build a VR clone like another app. VR app for crypto, VR app for your local niche, or VR app with AI advanced tools. Well, stay with me because I'll give you a step-by-step guide on how to do that, how to run this software business, how to use AI advantage, and how to create an MVP with a tiny budget. I'm Denis Babich, the director of a software development company. My team and I created more than 200 plus mobile and web apps. My goal today is to guide you through the framework of system architecture, validating your payment gateway idea, identifying benefits and challenges during the development process, navigate through the process of creating your VR app, sharing niche insights, and prepare you for your potential exit. Let's get started. Now, I'd like to be 100% transparent here. This video is not about how to code a VR app within 5 or 10 hours. Many YouTubers is doing that, but it's a huge fake. If so many companies out there hiring software engineers, paying them huge salaries to create an app within a 6 months period, then why do you think yet another YouTuber will give you a silver bullet on how to do that in 5 hours? Also, in the VR industry, creating a simple clone or interface in 15 minutes means nothing. VR, it's about experience, understanding niche market, and something truly powerful. One of the most important things in the VR industry is user experience. Look, if you're planning to create a clone of an existing clone, I have bad news for you. Because VR projects right now, it's all about new experiences. Do you remember why so many people played MMORPG games? Because it was a new experience. Your job when you're planning to create a VR startup is to find or invent a new experience for your users. You can't use for VR the same paradigm as for a web app. It's totally different tool. Look, I remember a few years ago, when it was at Samsung Galaxy Phone presentation in London, we managed to create a really cool and engaging new experience with VR inside their Hypercube, which includes music, lights, and dancing experience. Also, investors are willing to invest in the VR industry. Just take a look at the Y Combinator report regarding what niches they think are worth investments during the next decade. Your job is to create a fast and easy-to-use solution. Test the market fast. If it fails, release your code, your knowledge, pitch deck, and everything else, and quickly repeat. Look, your startup success is just a number of tries that you will do. So, when you're planning to create your VR app, you have to choose the platform where you will create your app. Also, right now we are in a new era of AI opportunities. Tools that create videos from your prompt are already out there. The video industry will have a significant boost using AI tools, and it will definitely affect the VR sector. So it's up to you if you wanna jump on this train before it's too late. Look, AI utilization right now, it's like a Bitcoin 10 years ago. So what you need to do to act fast and start making money with your VR? First, when you start your app development journey, many beginners fall into these standard traps. First, they often put all their energy into coding the product, especially if they come from a software development background. So at the end of the day, they have a software diamond, but they do not know how to run a business, how to do sales and marketing, how to manage finance, how to do a market research, how to build a team from scratch, how to fund the project, and how to adopt product to a rapid market changes. The next trap is when people jump into creating simple clones of existing products, which have lack of real value and industry knowledge, and don't address the real needs of their audience. It's those VR apps for an online marketplace, VR apps for video streaming, and VR apps for social networks. This approach is driven more by the founder's vision than by market demand, which leads to a quick failure, no clients, financial loss, and bankruptcy. Now, before you start your VR app development, there are two crucial things. First, shift your focus from creating a VR app to creating a business that solves real problems for your audience. This means understanding their needs, pains, and desires, and then creating your VR app as the solution. Second, remember that your resources, time, money, and motivation are limited. Business is a war, according to Sun Tzu. And here's another twist. You have to make one quick stride to break the reality and market defense, and win the war quickly. It's not about just doing more. It's about doing what's right and effective. Utilize the proper frameworks, tools, and strategies to achieve your goals with laser-focused and effective actions that we will discuss right now. Also, do you know why investors right now investing mostly only in startups that already have paying customers? Because this means that their founders managed to pass the reality check and use minimum resources to create a business from scratch, so they managed to do this war strike properly. When your business model is viable, then it's reasonable to scale it and invest in innovative services that can be a real game changer in the market. So what are the first step to achieve that? Create the MVP, minimum viable product. MVP is not just a buzzword, it's a philosophy of each and every process in your business, which means that you have to put all your focus and attention on things that are really important and get rid of all the unimportant nonsense. Picture this, you're aiming to build a VR app for online gambling. You're looking at user logging, video chat, 3D game, payments, and so on. But hold on a minute, do you truly need a video chat right now? Could you perhaps create a simple audio chat for better experience? And that all crypto coins support. Is it urgent? Maybe it's one of those things that can wait until your version 2.0? A few years back, we managed to create a VR app for online purchase experience. At the beginning, it was just a simple app where user can watch the video stream from a 360 camera. Then, when app received tons of great feedbacks, we managed to add a 3D online store where users can walk in a specific shop and purchase products, feeling presence experience. So, features are not solving the problem of your audience, and feature obsession, as I said earlier, can kill your startup. Let's be honest, no one expects that you will create the best product from day one, but people are always looking for a tool that will solve their specific problem, even if this tool is not perfect. Don't find customers for your products, find products for your customers. Seth Godin. But how to save money during the software development process and create a new experience for your users? Well, you have to identify your product market fit, which is basically a simple features list that will solve your users' problems. When you have this list, then you can develop only these features and cut all other nonsense. Which leads us that you have to offer innovative, engaging, and disruptive solution that address the pains and gains of your target audience. Thus, completing your value proposition table is the key to achieving that. Your goal is to find the pains and gains of your customers and give them something truly new. Basically, your goal is to create a new way how your VR app will engage with your users, similar to what Uber did with their mobile app and all taxi services. And always keep in mind that it's crucial to fall in love with your customer problems and not just your solutions. Okay, once you've done a deep dive into your customer needs, pinpointed all your customer problems, finished competitors' research, and come up with a bunch of engaging solutions, it's a perfect time to properly prioritize your software features to create your VR MVP. You have to figure out which features are must-haves, should-have, could-have, and won't be developed. Hidden gem. You would have to pivot a few times until you find a really perfect solution that will suit all your user needs. That's why limiting yourself with the amount of features for the MVP is so important. VR app mockups and the UI are not so important at this stage. Your goal is just to act fast and learn on the go. So, use existing VR templates and start creating something new from scratch only when your idea is validated by market demand. If you found value in these tips, please show your support by hitting that like button and subscribing to my channel. Your support will boost this video visibility in the YouTube algorithm, and you don't miss any valuable business videos from me. Thank you. Now, let's chat about the tech stack. So, if you're planning to create a VR app, it's essential to identify the platform that you will support. Also, it's important to identify the SDK that you will use, because your goal is not to reinvent the wheel. Your goal is to act fast, use Unity, and reuse existing code blocks and modules, especially at the early stage. Next, collecting user analytics is a crucial practice in the tech industry, allowing you to uncover essential things that you have to change and improve. At the early stage, you have to chat with each and every customer to understand their behavior and how they are using your app. What is boring? What is great? What things do they recommend to improve? Okay, if you're interested in delving deeper into the world of startups, AI, and businesses, do you want to connect with business-minded founders and entrepreneurs where I share tons of insights and host live chats? If so, click the link in the video description and join me on my Telegram channel right now. Here's a pro tip for you. If an investor contract requires an in-house development team, you will need to allocate a budget based on US or EU rates. However, you always have the option to outsource your software development expenditures to Ukraine, which can be a significant game changer when you're seeking value for money. Ukraine is an absolute hidden gem in the software development world. Many successful startups, such as GitLab, Grammarly, and Jubal, have already recognized the huge value of hiring Ukrainian developers to build top-notch software. Ukrainian developers have excellent English skills, extensive experience in outsourcing development, strong math background. They have innovative thinking, which help them always think outside of the box. On top of that, they are hard workers. Alright, if you want to build your VR app and you need my support, just shoot me a message via Calendly and we can have a 30-minute call about your problem and how we can transform it into a money-making machine. Yes, my software development services will cost you a dollar, but at the end of the day, you will have your VR app with the right set of features to disrupt the market and maybe even utilize the power of AI opportunity before it's too late. So, what you're waiting for? Schedule a meeting. Let's make it happen. See you.